everyone. Well, today we are going to learn one small Vedic mathematic trick. Now you can see on the whiteboard there are certain numbers written, and on the end of each number we have 5. So what is the simplest trick we use here? Suppose the number is 25 and we need to find out the square of 25. So we consider the first number as A, the second number as B. So the trick is very easy. I have written here just for your explanation. You can just do it verbally. You don't even require any external help. So if I write A, which is 2 plus 1, A is 2. So that means it's 3. 3 into 2 is 6. And 6, immediately copy 25 here. So the answer would be 25. So what you do is, you write 25 at the end of each number. Now suppose for this I write here 25, 25, 25, 25, 25, 25, and 25. Now for the rest we are going to follow this. Similarly 35, A plus B, that is 3 plus 1 is 4, 4 into 3 which will be 12. So 35 square is going to be 1225. 4 into 5, 20, 2025. 5 into 6, 3025. 6 into 7, 4225. 7 into 8, 5625. 9 into 8, 7225. 9 into 10, 9025. And 10 into 11 is 110. So just in 2 seconds, you have been able to find out the square of these numbers. Well, this is another trick which we are going to use mostly in competitive examinations. Now you may get a question similar to this as, count the total number of figures. So there's a very easy trick for it. Now if I see the first triangle, if I ask you to tell me the number of triangles, it's naturally 1. You don't have to count. But if you see the second image, you see here 3 triangles, and even they can be more. But the visible ones are point number 1, 2 and 3. I write down 1, 2, 3 here. Now if you want to count the total number of triangles in this image, what you will do is, you will find the maximum number here. The maximum, the highest number is 3 into 1 digit more than 3, higher than 3. What comes after 3? That is 4 divided by 2. Now solve it. 4 into 3, 12 by 2. That means the total number of triangle in this figure is 6. We can see the first one, 1, the second one, 2, the third one, 3. Now this is the fourth one, including 1 and 2. This is the fifth one, including 2 and 3. And the complete triangle one is 6. Now when I come to this triangle, again I write 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now the highest digit here is 4, which is 1 digit higher than 4, it's 5 by 2. So 5 into 4, 20 by 2 is 10. So you can simply put off 10 as the maximum number of triangles in this image. Now here I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly, we'll write 6 here. 6, one number higher, which is 7 by 2. 7 into 6, 42 by 2 gives you 21. Now if you start counting these 24 triangles, definitely it will cost you your time. So using this trick, you can easily find the maximum number of triangles or the figure in the complex images as well. Now these two triangles are a bit complex. In the previous triangle, we had a common base. But if you can see here, you cannot say that we have only one base. Base is this. In this triangle, you have one base. Along this, we have these two bases as well. So now how are we going to find out the total number of triangles in this figure? The concept is even simple here. You just number the bases. For example, if I talk about this bigger base, I put here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now talking about this base, I again number it as 1 and 2. Now which is the base left? The topmost. I again write it as 1 and 2. Now you don't have to do anything, just add these bases. 1 plus 2, 3. 1 plus 2, 3. 5, 4, 9, 3, 12, 13, 14, 15. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 gives you 21. This is how you're going to find out the total number of triangles in the figure. Coming on to this, now again, as I told you, just number the bases. Number 1, number 2, number 1, number 2. Don't put 3 and 4 here because these are separate triangle and the triangle base is different. 1 and 2 is the base of the bigger triangle. This 1 and 2 is the base of the smaller triangle. So do not write 3 and 4. They will be unique. Similarly, the smallest triangle here will have base of 1 and 2. Now the same step, 1 plus 2, 3, 1 plus 2, 3, 1 plus 2, 3. It gives you 9. As simple as that. Now what about these kind of questions? It's very difficult to find out the bases because somewhere you see an upright triangle, inverted triangle. Now how are you going to find out the bases? There's no need to find as such. There is another trick for such questions. The figure is given here. You have to find the triangle. The first one is easy, but still I tell you a trick here. What you can do is just write down the numbers in the simplest triangle which are visible to you. Now how many triangles are clearly visible here? 4. So I write here 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now the trick is write 4 here and multiply it by 2 which gives you 8. So there are total 8 triangles in this figure. Coming on to this, a bit complex than the simple one. Now like I told you in the previous example, right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. How many total triangles which are commonly visible to you? They are 8. And now if you have to find out the total number of triangles, simply multiply it by 2, that gives you 16. So if you had option here, how many triangles are there? Somebody said 21, somebody would say 15, somebody would say 12, somebody would say 16. So you don't have to count them one by one. You just have to use the simple trick and put 16 as the correct option. Well, this is going to be the last trick for today. I won't burden you much. Now, these are very common type of questions. If you have ever attempted any competitive examinations, you would have seen such questions. Now, how much time do you expect yourself to give into these questions? Suppose if they are even 2 or 3 questions in an entire paper, you are going to add 5, double 5, triple 5, 4 times 5. I think that's going to take your time. So what simple thing we can do is, the trick of this question says, write on the first digit here, which is 4. Now just count how many 4 are there in all the 3 numbers. Here I just have 1, here I have 2, here I have 3. So the simplest trick is 4 into 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now here you can simply multiply 4 and you get here 4, 9, 2. Simple. Now if I talk about here, simple 5, then here it's 1, 2, 3 and 4. So what is the trick? 5 into 1, 2, 3, 4. Just multiply here, 5 into 4, 20, 5, 3, 16, 17 and this is going to be 6, 1, 7, 0. So children, I hope you must have enjoyed these little small few tricks. Now I'm going to give you a few questions, attempt them and try to utilize your time in learning new things. Keep learning and keep sharing. Have a great day.